Yeah. in 2020. He said, I will take my place in your health in 2020. He said, I will take your place, I will take my place in every situation in 2020. Oh, we worship you, Father. Just lift up your hands this evening and worship you.
Let's do it again.
Forever.
22. Psalm 107, verse 22. It says, let them sacrifice the sacrifices of thanksgiving and declare his works with rejoicing. Tonight, I want us to bring forth a thanksgiving sacrifice unto the Lord. You've probably been doing it all day, but David said something. He said, 7 times in a day, I will give you thanks. So we're not going to get tired of giving God thanks for 2019. So lift up your voice again tonight. Say, Lord, I give you thanks for 2019. I bring my sacrifice of thanks unto you tonight. Father, because I can testify that you have been so good to me. Come on, we need to think back on all that he did each and every month of this year. Oh, thank him that you are standing.
Thank you.
for supernatural exploits in April. Come on, thank him, thank him. For supernatural celebration in May, Father, we thank you. For supernatural living, we thank you. For supernatural lifting in July, we thank you. For supernatural love, we thank you. Oh, in the month of September, for the supernatural ideas that you gave us, we say thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you for the supernatural transformation that you brought about in the month of October. We say thank you, Father, for supernatural release that you gave us in November. Thank you, Father, for all that was held captive, all that was held from us, you released unto us in the month of November. Father, Lord, we say thank you for supernatural visitation in this month of December. Come on, thank you for visiting you with joy, with peace, with favor. Thank you. Thank you for visiting you with good news. Thank you for visiting you with revelation. Oh, Father, we praise and we glorify you. We thank you, Abba Father, for all that you did in this year. We come back to you, Lord, and we say unto you and unto you alone be all the glory, all the honor, all the adoration, O Lord. Lord, we stand here tonight knowing that we may not have received everything that we've trusted you for this year, but you are the only reason why we have not lost everything. And for this, Father, we say thank you. Love you, Lord. As we proceed in this service with Holy Spirit, have your way. Tabernacle with us in this place tonight. Let each and every person meet with you face to face in the name of Jesus. Lord, let rejoicing be the order of the day. We give you praise and glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Come on, somebody shout out loud, loud, loud.
Similar interests, because we believe that God has not called us to live life alone. We ask you to please be a part of our connect groups and also our discipleship growth track classes that also get you on a spiritual foundation, help build your spiritual foundation, and get you off on that path to living a successful life with Christ. Amen. We believe that God will bless you as you are part of those two things. Amen. We're here tonight. Tonight, it's a service unusual, as you can tell. We're going to be thanking God in prayer. We're going to be thanking God in praise. And so I want you tonight to tell your neighbor, say, excuse me. don't get in my way tonight. I said, don't get in my way tonight. Amen, amen. So I want to take some special, just a few minutes this evening, to welcome some very special people in our midst. If you're worshiping with us for the very first time in DIC Cyprus, can I please see you wave your hand where you are? I know there's a few people in the congregation. My sister, you're welcome. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Amen. Thank you so much for worshiping with us tonight. We know you're a part of our extended family here in DIC Cyprus. And we encourage you to please be a part of what God is doing here. If you can, please text the word connect. Text the word guest. The word guest. I'm so excited tonight. I'm just messing up my words. If you can, please text the word guest to 832-789-4949 to fill out our connect card, or in the seat pocket in front of you, please fill out some information so that we can reach out to you after the service and be a blessing to you. Amen. God bless you as you have come. All right, let's take this to the next level. We're going to be sharing testimony. So I want to encourage you tonight, think back to what the Lord has done in your life and come up here and testify. Any testimony that you have that God gave you in 2019, make sure you don't carry it into 2020. Amen? Don't carry it into 2020. So as Brother Charles comes up, please start to prepare your testimonies. Let's put our hands together.
It's testimony time. It's testimony time. As Pastor Tony said, please, before you come up, let me just encourage you. Make room for 2020 testimonies. Giving your testimony for 2019. Do not take it over. Do not cross over with 2019 testimonies. Amen? You know why we share testimonies? Mainly to encourage someone, to boost somebody else's faith. And also, we testify to show that our God is even greater than we can ever think or imagine. So, this is the time for our testimonies. I encourage everyone. We all put our hands up when Pastor Tommy said, have you been enlarged in 2019? Therefore, everybody should be testifying. So please, put your hands together as you come up for your testimonies, please. Let's encourage those who are coming up with their testimonies. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, we're going to hire you. I'd like to see everybody stand, please, and come up for testimonies. Praise the Lord.
Okay. My name is Elijah. So, I mean, the summary of my testimony for 2019 is that income-wise, it's the highest I've ever made. Time-wise, I've never worked this little in my life. I mean, my neighbors think I'm retired. So, there's just a lot there, but you know, we can talk one-on-one. Secondly, I want to thank God because it's been about 2.5 years since my mom was diagnosed with cancer. I was able to go home in November and spend some time with her. I don't know what the doctors are talking about, but she seems fine to me. But
faithfulness. My gratitude for 2019, God answered every single thing that's in my place. Now, there's one thing left on that sheep that I'm yet to see, and it's the reason I'm standing here tonight, because I know that all my children are going to testify. Yes. On this same pulpit, God help me gather next time, the same time next year.
Praise the Lord! Praise the living Jesus.
My name is Ronnie. I just want to thank God for what He did, what He's done for me this year. I tell you, everything on my ship was achieved this year. To the glory of God. Everything on that list, God gave them to me, answered my prayers. And I want
to thank God for it. I got the Lord to start naming them what God did it. And at times when you come to church, they tell you to write the whole sheet and lift it up. The things of God are foolishness to man. Please lift them up and believe it is possible. God is able.
God, all things are possible. Amen.
My name is Boston. I just really want to thank God for my life. This year, like, there's been a lot of school shootings and all going on. Black girls going missing and all. So I just really want to thank God for my life and keep it.
Thank God for protection. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, church. My name is Joanna Monogo. I'm on to Tobia Monogo. To God be the glory. First of all, my testimony are in twofolds. I want to testify on behalf of DIC Cyprus. I was here some time ago when you started, not quite a year, and look at how big the market is. And last year, when we were told about supernatural enlightenment, I took it home with me. I shared my testimony with my church. I said, believe God. He's a God of our, we say he's a God of bigness in Nigeria. And look at how, just look at God, he's a big God. And nothing big comes out of being small. God is not small. And your testimonies cannot be small. As you wake up day by day, please think of the big God. And by the grace of God, annually I do the grammar round. I go from here to Houston to India to everywhere. And the flights have been smooth. The devotion said I'm there, and my business, God has been faithful. I can't ask for more, but our God is a more much. He's ready to do more for me 2020. To God be the glory.
Good evening, my name is Marie, or whichever one. I have two. I want to thank God for my family first, like from my extended family to my close family. They're always really supportive of me and of what I want to do. And my second one, this month was presentation. Yeah. Like throughout the month, God has been revealing a lot of stuff to me. And about 2 nights ago, he visited me in a dream and I was like shocked. I was really shocked, but I'm glad that I remember the message that he told me. So I'm gonna fulfill it in 2020.
I just can't thank God for the sufficiency. He has been so grateful to me. This year I did the surgery for my eye. It was successful. And I did the last surgery for cyst. It was successful. Travel so much. God always grants them, all my children, to have blessings. And for the celebration of my daughter that she did, it was very successful.
So they were singing, Jesus Conquered the Grave. So I took my time to get into that song. And right there, I rebuked the band immediately. Surprisingly, they let this up. Another testimony I want to give is early this year, we purchased some new equipment that brought our POS, my entire POS, to at $2,000 every month. From January till now, we didn't even pay anyone late. It's nothing that the entire equipment we are running, just few of the equipment on the road. How God did it, and how He's even us to do it again, I don't know. Just give him all the glory. One time I got a speeding ticket. They took me to the church. I saw to look prank. They discharged that it's only one of that one I've been testifying. I saw to look prank and they discharged that ticket. So I give into that ticket, into that prayer he prayed. Brethren, throughout this year, I didn't even get a single ticket. Another thing that surprised me is that even when they're supposed to give me a ticket, the man will shake my hand and say, no.
My 2019 lessons into 2020.
This year was one of those years where my entire family traveled a lot. I was taking time to go through my praise log, and I can't remember how many trips we took. It was a lot of road trips. It was a lot of air trips. And the Lord kept us through. I never take it for granted that He takes us out and He brings us back in. So I give God the glory for divine protection. Also this year, both of my children are very active. Both of our children are very active in sports. And I went back and counted last night because the Lord reminded me that, you know, they haven't had any injuries. They haven't had any accidents in all of their sporting events. So I went back and I tried to count how many sporting events they had this year. It was over 70. And the Lord kept both of them. And He's still keeping them. Amen. This year on my goal sheet, the Lord has done just about everything that was impossible for me to do. Remember, God always does what we cannot do. Amen. And He did it. One of my desires this year for my birthday, you know, everyone was asking, what do you want for your birthday and all that. But I told my husband, I'm not a party person, so I didn't really want a party for my birthday. And I really wanted to go on a cruise. My family has never been on a cruise before. So I put that on my goal sheet. While that was there, we went down to being a two-income family to a one-income family this year. So even though things were looking bleak, I still trusted God. And as God would have it, someone asked my husband when he was on assignment, asked him, you know, what does your wife want for her birthday? And he told the person, and the person said, all right, go ahead and purchase it. I will pay for it. And that was what God did. So my last person going on and that was that. Those are just a few of the things that God has done. So I just want to use that to encourage us, everyone that's sitting and listening to this tonight, that there is nothing too hard for God to do. We just have to have faith and believe that He will do it, and He will surely do it in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Valently,
so I want to thank God for His faithfulness all throughout this year. Just generally, so much happened within my family, extended family, nuclear family, and God was just faithful through it all. And most importantly, I want to specifically thank God for the help of our daughter, Jada Christine. She was born with some complications at birth, and God just continues to heal her over and over again. This year, we've gone to the doctor, what I mean, significantly less than we've done in the past. Just going to continue to just see perfection when it comes to her in Jesus' name. Praise
the living Jesus.
Hi, oh, my name is Toby, and give me 1 minute to just say my thanks to God. God, I look to You. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like You do. God, I safety. I just want to say thank You, God, for a beautiful 2019. I give God a praise. want to glorify God. I want me to. I will sing all the mercies of the
I want to be debt free by the end of this year.
And it came to pass in August this year, we had only 6 days to pay $12,000. When my husband told me, I said, well, I don't know what to do. I'm going to pray and ask God to help us. And to the glory of God, within that 6 days, $12,000 was paid. You brought me here and you are going to deal with it, and God dealt with it in a miraculous way. So I just want to say thank you to God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hi, my name is Adesla. I just wanted to thank God for my family, and then also in the beginning of 2019 for crossover night last year. I wrote down on my goal sheet different things, and I didn't think that God would make it, you know, come to pass. I was able to get a new car this year. I have no idea how that happened, and I just give God all the glory.
Jesus. Praise the Lord. I just want to thank God for the goodness of God, for the grace of God upon my life. He has helped me to give a feast at my home.
Hallelujah.
I just want to thank God. You can hear my husband testifying about how much we need to pay every month. And the one in the house, I always ask God, Holy Spirit, what do I need to do? When I see the account is red, I say, Father, it's holy, holy, the Holy Spirit will tell me what to do and cover those things. Hallelujah. And nothing ever return. And I give God all the glory. The money is there, but our business is very challenging in cash flow. I'm looking at the paperwork. The money is there, but the cash is not there. Praise the Lord. God has been so faithful. I give him all the glory. I give him all the honor. He is a great maker. He will continue to make a way in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. We will continue to make a way for you, amen.
My name is Fulaya Joseph, and I want to take back the testimony I had before, the first time here. It was so gloomy. I think I've been ungrateful. God has been so faithful in my life. I moved from Chicago because it was cold. And the children are grown, so I came. And God planted my feet in Houston, even though I didn't know anybody. But it's been, since May, it's been like 7 months, and it felt like I've been in Houston for like a whole 10 years. I have a whole family, people call me all the time. And then I love my job. I was afraid I won't like it. You know, when you just uproot yourself suddenly and you trust God, and then things happen, and then you stop trusting God, that's not good enough. So I learned my lesson, but my job has been going on wonderful. But the most important testimony, if you didn't come to church yesterday, you missed. I came to church. I think we were a few people, so we all collected all the other people's stuff. Because I had a meeting. It was supposed to be due on Sunday, and I was talking to Pastor. Anything you want to do, you just go ahead and your sister for me. Just don't think about anything. So I got home. I didn't eat. I said, okay, I'm just going to keep this fasting and then see if I can do the paper. I did my meter and I didn't understand some of them. I don't understand some of the questions. I started winging it. And I turned it in and I closed my eyes. And it was 75 out of 75. First time.
This testimony is from the Anthony's. He said, praise the Lord, brethren. We are grateful to the Lord for all the good things he has done in our family in the year 2019. Among the many miracles and wonders of God over our family are the few below. We thank God for the gift of life and salvation of souls, his protection over us traveling back and forth
for work and family activities. His unlimited provision for our family, giving my wife a residence permit plus other valid documents, safe delivery for our baby, and providing full funding. Helping our Connect Group. This is the importance of Connect Group now. Helping our Connect Group to grow and increasing his presence amongst us. The growth of DIC Cyprus and all the wonderful testimonies thus far allow me to complete 3 certifications this year, enlarging our territories starting from December 2019. Everything he will do for us as a family and church in the year 2020. All glory to our God. Now finally, last but not the least, this year I had some pains in my chest and I talked to Pastor about it. I thought that I went to the gym and I was lifting weights that were too heavy, but the pain will not go away. I spoke to my wife a few times and she said, I think it's muscle. But sometimes when you go to the doctors, instead of them telling you that everything is okay, they make you more frightened. So, but I kept declaring because, you know, I started feeling this pain sometime in August. Never went to the doctors until September because I was believing that the pain was nothing. But when I went to the doctor, they started talking to me about my heart. Oh, it looks like you might have had a heart attack, and so on and so forth. I said, that's not my portion. But to God be the glory, they asked me to go see a cardiologist. And I went to see the cardiologist, and he looked, and he did all the tests, every test that you can think of, he did. And then at the end of it all, he said, Mr. Gillespie, what are you doing here? I don't need to see you for the next 6 months. I don't even need to see you in a year, because you're fine, you're doing well. So I just want to give God all the glory that your trust should not be in what man can do. Your trust should be in God, because it is He who makes a way, like the sister said, where there seems to be no way. Praise the Lord. Now let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for this awesome, awesome, awesome testimonies. Thank you, Lord, for that which you are doing in the lives of your children. Thank you for the wonderful works in 2019. Father, Lord God, everyone here has a testimony because you made a way. Everyone here had a testimony because you did something to enlarge them, to grow them. Oh, Father, to heal them. We have come back, Lord, to say thank you. Thank you, Lord God, for your favor. Thank you for your protection. Thank you for your provision. Thank you for supernatural enlargement. We give you all the praise. We cover all of these testimonies in the blood of Jesus. And we decree and declare that they are permanent, even in the lives of all of your children. Father, if there's anyone here who's looking for wonderful things in their lives, like you've already done, that you will know that you are not a respecter of persons, do it for them also. We give you all the praise and all the glory. Blessed be your holy name forevermore. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Now put your hands together as we welcome Brother Sonny.
Praise the Lord. Shall we be on our feet? This is the time for us to have a prayer, trusting God for 2020. Hallelujah. In a minute, just let us give God the glory for his testimonies. It is not an easy task. It's not something we can take for granted. The goodness of the Lord, the blessings of the Lord over our brothers and sisters. The Lord has showed himself approved in their lives. It is not something we're going to take for granted. Lord, we thank you, faithful Father, for all these testimonies. We give you all the glory, Father. Many even have testimonies to give, but for one reason or the other, they just want to postpone it. Father, we say thank you on your behalf. We appreciate you, faithful Father. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Bible to the book of Psalm 1. The book of Psalm 1, verses 1 to 3. Book of Psalm 1, verses 1 to 3. Million nice. Okay, say, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsels of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sit in the seat of the scornful. 2. Verse 2. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and his law he meditate day and night. But the third one, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that brings forth its fruit in his season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. Praise the Lord. Brethren, we are going to pray right now. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, disassociate me from those who are toxic to my life. As we enter 2020, begin to pray. Say, Father, disassociate me, disengage me, separate me from people who are toxic, whose lives are toxic to my future, whose lives are toxic to my spiritual life, whose lives are toxic to my career, whose lives are toxic to my ministry. Because there are people who are against your life, there are people who are against your destiny, there are people who are against your future. Father, we say disengage us, disassociate us from those people in the name of Jesus, because they are not helping us fulfill our ministry. They are not helping us fulfill our destiny. They are not helping us fulfill our career. They are not helping us fulfill the ministry God has put in our hands. Therefore, Father, as we go into 2020, disassociate us from this kind of people. Separate us from this kind of people. Give us a spirit of discernment that we might know them. I don't care what you benefit from them. But if they are not helping you to reach your future, to make your destiny happen, we pray, God, separate us from them all. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to also look to the next verse 19. Verse 3. It says, verse 3, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bring forth his fruit in this season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Brethren, say in the name of Jesus, whatever I lay my hand next year must prosper. Begin to pray. Begin to declare, whatever you lay your hand upon, it shall prosper. Whatever is your career, whatever is your ministry, whatever is your business, whatever you lay your hand, so as far as it's legitimate, it shall prosper. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's see Psalm 71 from 19 to 20. Psalm 71, 19 to 20. Psalm 71, 19 to 20. Psalm 71, 19 to 20. Okay. 19 says, also your righteousness, O God, is very high. You who have done great things, O God, who is like unto you. Say, our Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for such a wonderful things you have done for us in 2019. Begin to pray. We thank you because you are so incomparable. We thank you because there is nothing too difficult for you to do. We can't compare you with anybody because you have been so dreadful. You are God by yourself. Beside you, there is no other God. Father, we thank you because you are righteous. Your righteousness is bigger. Your righteousness is wider. Your righteousness is deeper even than our situation. Oh, Father, we thank you. Lord, we love you. Lord, we appreciate you because you have been a faithful Father. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Verse 20, you who have shown me great and severe troubles shall revive me again and bring me up from the depth of the earth. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I don't have time to explain all this scripture. Say, our Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for whatsoever hardship we have gone through in 2019. Because he declared in the book of Romans 28, verse 8 to 8, he said, for we know that all things work together for good to them that love the Lord, and to them the Lord has called according to his purpose. So let us begin to thank him for whatever we have gone through this year. Not necessarily the blessings, but whatever negative thing we have gone through, let us thank him. Because we don't know what would have happened if it didn't happen. Father, we thank you, mighty God. For what you have done for us this year, even though you might not be a blessing, but you are such an awesome God. Because we may have lost many things, we may have been alone, we may have been struggling to put one foot in front of the other to keep moving forward in this world. But the Lord will comfort you, the Lord will restore you to peace and life again. Every pain will end in this 2019. In the name of Jesus, your hope in Christ Jesus will be restored in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Let us see the book of Genesis. Genesis 22:5. Genesis 22:5. I'm going to be concluding with this because of time. Genesis 22:5. And Abraham said to his young man, he said, stay here with the donkey. The Lord and I will go yonder and worship, and we will come back to you. Praise the Lord. What is Abraham saying here? Abraham was to sacrifice Isaac. But when they got to the foot of the mountain, he asked his servants to stay. Brethren, why didn't he go to the mountain with his servants? It's because those guys' faith cannot take them to the mountain. Let us pray that, Lord, as we enter 2020, may I not be a foot mountain Christian, but I should be a top mountain Christian. Tell somebody, see you at the top. Tell somebody, see you at the top. Begin to pray, begin to declare, I will never be a foot mountain Christian, but I will be a top mountain Christian. I will never be a foot mountain Christian, but I will be a top mountain Christian. Father, I will not be a top mountain Christian. I may have been a foot mountain Christian this year, but next year, Lord, I will be a top mountain Christian in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, finally, Abraham said, I am going to worship the Lord with this land. We are going to pray now. There is a given, Pastor Tolu was teaching us sometime. He says, when your praise comes from your heart, it is no longer religious. It becomes a relationship with you and God. The same thing with your giving. That is the level of giving you will give to God. It is no longer giving. It comes to worship. So what we are saying is, as we enter 2020, the giving that will move God is not going to be mere giving. It's going to be worshiping God with our substance. Hallelujah. Begin to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, grant me the grace to worship you with my substance. Begin to pray. Begin to pray that. Hallelujah. Father, we worship you with our substance. We worship you with our offering. We worship you with our tithe. We worship you with our seed. We worship you with whatever you have blessed us with. In the name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, take us to the next level of giving, that we no longer stay below, that each time we give you, it must come from our heart. We are not giving from our intuition. We are not giving from our personal mind, but we are giving you from our heart. Because when it comes from our heart, it is no longer given. It has come to worship. That when we worship you, we will worship you in spirit and in truth. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for your time. In Jesus' name we pray. And we say,
Thank you. up standing. We are going to be praying tonight. Hallelujah. Thank God for 2019. God has been faithful. And we are going to be praying the wisdom of God for 2020. Hallelujah. So I have the next 8 minutes for us to pray. And I trust the Lord to help us understand His wisdom for 2020. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 7. Say, but we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the ages for our glory. Hallelujah. There is a wisdom that God has planned for 2019 for us. And the scripture here says, God has hidden that wisdom for us, for our glory, as a commission, as a church. God has told us that the 2020 is going to be our year of breakthrough unlimited. But for individual here, there are certain things also God has planned and packaged for us. And so tonight we are going to be unveiling those things. We are going to be praying and asking the Lord to unveil to us what He has for us in 2020. Just to give you an idea concerning Jesus, verse 8 says, which none of the rulers of these ages knew. You see, the wisdom that we're going to be praying about tonight, nobody knows about it. Not even the devil. He made the same mistake with Jesus. He said, for had they known, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. You see, if Satan knew that what Satan was going to do was going to bring glory to Jesus, he wouldn't have done it. So there is that wisdom God had hid from the devil that we are going to be praying tonight. The Bible says, the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. And when you read the scripture in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2, it says, for he that speaketh in an unknown tongue speaketh not unto men, but unto God. No one understands him. Howbeit, in the Spirit, he speaks what? That mystery. So tonight, I don't know about you, but for me, I'm here to say, Lord, I want to do business with you for the next 7 minutes. Unveil to me the wisdom for 2020. Are you getting what I'm saying? So this evening, I'm going to ask you to just lift up your voice. If you have the heavenly language, if you can pray in the Holy Ghost tonight, just begin to unleash yourself in the presence of God. Because the wisdom of God for the new year that we are getting into, God is going to unveil that to somebody. God is going to open us up to that tonight. In the name of Jesus. And I trust God that in the next few minutes, God will open that up, will reveal that He has planned for you and your family, particularly in this new year that we are entering. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. on your understanding in all your ways. Acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. So this evening, I would like you to begin to ask the Lord and say, Lord, in 2020, direct my path. Every second of the way, every minute of the way, every hour, every day, in this new year that we're getting into, direct my path, Father, direct my path, in the name of Jesus. For the hours and for the minutes and the seconds ahead, we give you praise. Because you've gone before us and you've cleared all the crooked ways. You've made them straight. All the mountains before us have become plain, and all the valley have been filled. We give you glory. Thank you for breakthrough unlimited. We exalt you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Come on, put those hands together. Come on, do it loud, 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 do it loud. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated briefly. We're still going to pray tonight. God bless you for being in His presence tonight. You are in His presence to cross over into your covenant year of breakthroughs unlimited. Yeah. Come on, someone say amen. Yeah. I'm so grateful to God for what He has done in our lives in this year 2019. You heard those amazing testimonies. How many people are so grateful for everything that God has done? You see, it is only proof that God will multiply every single thing that we saw this year. That's why we took time to thank Him. That's why we took time to say, thank you, Lord. Because thanksgiving always multiplies whatever it is that you're giving God thanks for. So that is that all those testimonies that we heard tonight, God will multiply them in our lives in the name of Jesus. Come on, someone say amen to that. Tonight is not a night of sermonizing anyone. I just want to kind of lay a foundation for us on what to expect for the year 2020. And I'm so grateful that the people of God that have come up here to minister, every single one of them just confirm everything God has been ministering to us since we're preparing for 2020. Every single one of them. So I want you to be expectant in what God will do in the year 2020. You know why? Your expectation will never be disappointed. Come on, say amen to that. Your expectation will be fulfilled. Your expectation will be exceeded. Amen. But it's so important that your expectation is high. When God wants to change a man's destiny, when God wants to change a man's life, the first thing He does is to release a word ahead of him. When God wants to change your level, when God wants to change your season, the first thing He does is to release a word ahead of you. That word becomes your anchor. That word becomes your confidence. That word becomes what you hold on to regardless of what is going on around you.
And God said, I should tell someone, be expectant in what I will do in the year 2020. He said, I will give you your daily bread. Oh, come on, so like that amen is not born again. Remember, I told you we don't say amen to fill in space. We say amen to receive divine verdict. We say amen to receive what God has said you do. So he said in the year 2020, he will give you your daily bread. Amen. We saw that in that scripture that we read in Revelation chapter 22 from verse 1. Let me read it to you again. Revelation chapter 22 from verse 1. Verse 1 and 2. He says, and he showed me the pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding from the throne of God and of the Lamb. Verse 2 said, in the middle of its street and on either side of the river was the tree of life, which bore 12 fruits, each tree yielding its fruit every month. Someone say every month.
Every month.
Say it one more time. Say every month.
Every month.
The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. So every month in the new year, God will give you your daily bread.
Amen.
Come on, someone say amen to that.
Amen.
So, Usher, go ahead and pass out. Go ahead and pass out the overview of the year 2020 calendar of events. Please pass it out. And on the very back side, you see what God wants to do every year. Every month of that year. Because God never lies. Someone say God never lies. Say with me, say God never lies. He said, I will give to you your daily bread every single month. Not only that, God says, I will divinely guide you. You heard what the man of God said? He said, we need wisdom. Wisdom for the year 2020. Why? Because God wants to divinely guide you. God will divinely guide you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Come on, someone say amen to that.
Amen.
And finally, God said, be expectant because you are going to sing of my goodness. Someone say amen to that.
Amen.
So, what is the word that he has given to us for the year 2020? That anchor scripture is in the book of Psalm 102. Psalm 102 verse 13. If I can have it on the screen, please. Psalm 102 verse 13. It says, you will arise and have mercy on Zion for the set time to favor her. Yes, the set time has come. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet. I'm going to give you about 60 seconds to pray this. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, according to your word, 2020 is my time to be favored. Favor me in the name of Jesus. Come on, go ahead and pray that prayer. Come and lead that prayer.
Go on with that prayer. Say, 2020 is the year the Lord will favor me. 2020. Begin to pray. 2020 is the appointed time. Is appointed year. Is appointed time. Is appointed year for your travel. It is appointed time for your travel. It is appointed time for your travel. The appointed set time has come, and it is coming in less than 2 hours from now. It's coming in less than 2 hours from now. Because 2020 is your year. It's your year of breakthroughs unlimited. The year of your breakthroughs unlimited. And that is also your year of favor. The time to favor you has come. The time to favor you has come. The time to favor you has come. Time to favor you has come. the Lord will never leave you untroubled. You must be troubled. You must be troubled. You must be troubled. You must be troubled. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. That is a powerful scripture in the book of Psalm 102, verse 13.
Chronologically, that's where we get that word, right? One after the other.
And then there are some times when he just opens a window in time called Kairos. Like, he just opens that window, like, it's just time. I just want to have favor on somebody. And he just opens that window. God said that that window is 2020. Yeah. I've opened it to favor you. Yeah. I've opened it to do breakthroughs unlimited. Yeah. That'll be your experience in the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah. God says it's time for you to walk in the fullness of his word concerning you. So it means that for someone in this place, there are no more limitations. Someone say no more limitations. It does not matter your age, it does not matter your gender, it does not matter whatever, it's your time, so no more limits. My daughter just started driving. Why? Because she turned 16. Now, because I know she's like me, I did everything to let her go slow before she starts driving. But because she knew it was her time, because she knew it was her season, she did not even wait for me. She did all the registration herself, did all the online thing, and all I had to do was sign. Why? Said, Dad, it's my time. Dad, it's my season to drive. So it does not matter what your dad said, no more limitations. It's my season. And that's what God is saying concerning your 2020. No more limitations maritally. No more limitations financially. No more limitations concerning that immigration case. But I love what he said. He said it also means that we are taking new territories. Oh, somebody catch that. See, in 2020, you are going to be doing something you have never done before. You see, that's why I told you to write down your goal sheets. You see, when we were saying it last year, I knew some people were skeptical. But you heard the testimonies tonight. Look, listen, God never lies. I said God never lies. Numbers 23:19 said, God is not a man that he should lie. God never lies. If God says that there is a door through here, believe it or not, when you get there, the door will be there. Yours is to believe God. So when God says you are going to take over new territories, that means that somebody is going to be doing what they have never done before. That means that some people will start new lines of business they never started before. That means some people will take on new projects they've never taken on before. That's what it means. But it's something that you have never done before. Look at it. When Israel had suffered 430 years in Egypt, when their time was up, God said, I remember my people in Israel. Their cry and their prayer have come to me. It's time for me to set them free. And guess what he did? He took them from the land of Egypt to a new territory they had never been before. He took them to their Canaan land that they had never been before. That will be someone's experience in 2020 in the name of Jesus. What you have never done, what you have never seen, you will handle it in 2020. But how is this going to happen? How is this all going to happen? Someone say the presence of God. Say it one more time, say the presence of God. That's how it's going to happen. The man of God, Moses, said, Lord, if your presence will not go with us, we don't want to leave this place. If the presence of God does not go with us into 2020, it will be an ordinary year. But God said, my presence has already gone ahead of you. Amen. And 2020 will deliver beyond your wildest imagination. Amen. His presence. His presence. It's the reason why we said you must develop a lifestyle of praise. You must develop a lifestyle of praise. It is your lifestyle of praise that attracts his presence to you. The atmosphere in which God dwells is the atmosphere of praise. Read Revelation, you see there. Any one of his children that praises him as a lifestyle, he never lacked the manifest presence of God. Every single one of them. When you embrace a lifestyle of praise, you will not have any prayer points in 2020. All you will just have will just be praise galore. Why? Because the presence of God will envelop you. The Bible says he inhabits the praises of his people. The abode, the environment, the habitat in which God abides is praise. That's why we must do it as a lifestyle. Because if we don't do it as a lifestyle, you are shortchanging yourself. Because the breakthroughs are limited, like I said, will happen. It takes your participation in what God wants to do. Why? Because his presence makes a difference. His presence makes a difference. But you need to engage praise. Look at what it says. I believe it's in the book of Psalm 114. Just to show you the power of his presence. Psalm 114 from verse 1. Let me read it to you. Psalm 114 from verse 1 through 8. Look at what the Bible says. It said, when Israel went out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of a strange language. He said, Judah became his sanctuary. What's another name for Judah? Oh, I can't hear you. What's another name for Judah? Praise. He said, praise became his sanctuary and Israel his dominion. Verse 3, he said, the sea saw it and fled. Jordan turned back. Verse 4, the mountains skipped like rams. The little hills like lambs. Then the question was asked, what ails you, O sea, that you fled? O Jordan, that you turned back? O mountains, that you skipped like rams? Or, O little hills, like lambs? Verse 7, let's read verse 7 and 8 together. I want to go. Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord. At the presence of the God of Jacob. Verse 8, who turned the rock into a pool of water, the flint into a mountain of water. That's it. Whatever mountain wants to try to stop you in 2020, the presence of God will destroy them in the name of Jesus. It does not matter the mountain. Mountain of financial hardship, mountain of immigration status, mountain of marital woes. All of that will bow to the presence of God. That's the difference. When you walk in the reality of that, when you walk in the understanding of that, you'll find that you'll be swimming in breakthroughs unlimited in the name of Jesus. Not only must we embrace a lifestyle of praise, we're going to be exploring it in the course of all the teachings, you know, throughout 2020. Just whetting your appetite on what to expect and what and how to position yourself in the coming year. You must also be prompt in obeying God with absolute trust. Someone say, I must obey God with absolute trust. Let me tell you why. In the coming year, what time is it now? It's 11:26. You see, I told you. In the coming year, God will be bringing opportunities your way you never thought about. But you see, those opportunities will be wrapped up in unfamiliar things. And he will nudge you to go ahead and take it. Your prompt obedience with absolute trust is the key. Your prompt obedience with absolute trust is the key. I was talking to my dear sister yesterday, and she was just sharing some things. And the moment she shared it, God reminded me of what I'm telling you now. An opportunity she did not ask for. An opportunity she did not apply for. An opportunity she was not even in her radar. She said, Pastor, they're asking me to come and head this unit. And I'm saying, but I don't think I want to do it because, you know, I want to. The moment she told me, I said, my sister, take it. I said, take it. She now even went to review that. It's not even one opportunity, it's two to come and head the unit. I said, take it. The one that they said you have to start with, take it. And there will be a lot of experiences like that in 2020 for us in the name of Jesus. Yeah. An opportunity she didn't apply for. An opportunity, but not in our area, that is taking new territories. That will be your experience in the name of Jesus. Amen. But what's the key? Your prompt obedience with absolute trust. Your prompt obedience with absolute trust. It's so important we understand that. Don't analyze. Don't calculate. The moment the Holy Spirit nudges you, take step in. Because the opportunities of a lifetime must be taken in the lifetime of the opportunity. In other words, he opens it for a moment, you step in, and you're good. Remember the guy at the pool of Siloam? The Bible says that an angel comes once a year to come and stir up the water. And whoever gets into the pool first becomes healed. But his own problem was he never was taking advantage of the opportunity. You know what he was saying? He was always saying that, well, there's no one to help me into the water. That was his excuse for years and years and years. So please, don't let any excuse stop your opportunity in 2020. Yeah. Don't say, oh, I don't think I'm educated enough. Oh, I don't think, you know, I'm old enough. Oh, I don't think I'm too old. Oh, I think it's the color of my skin. Who said? I've told you in this place, all you need is God. As long as you have the backing of God, that's all you need. The backing of God. The backing of God. So, prompt obedience with absolute trust. In other words, your capacity to believe God in the coming year will determine your experience. Because let me tell you something. In this kingdom, everything we get from God, we get using the currency of faith. The Bible says, without faith, Hebrews 11:6, without faith, it is impossible to please God. But he that comes to God must believe that he is, and is the reward of him that diligently seek him. As long as your faith is intact, you find that you will always keep experiencing unlimited open opportunities on a daily basis. And that will be your experience in Jesus' name. Amen. Look at Deuteronomy 8, verse 1. Just to buttress that from the scriptures. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 1. The Bible says, every commandment which I command you today, you must be careful to observe. Can you see that? That you may live and multiply and go in and possess the land of which the Lord has sworn to your fathers. You must be careful to obey. You must be careful. So don't be careless in the coming year. I beg you. Don't be careless with whatever God tells you to do. Don't be careless with the word of God. Don't be careless with the instruction of God. See, I know believers, our main problem is that we are very, very negligent when God tells us to do things. We take things for granted too much. Listen, because God is a God who is guided by his word, the Bible said that he exalts his word above all his names. And you know God's names are powerful. The Bible says, at the mention of the name of the Lord, said he bows in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. He said all of that, he exalts what he says about that. So when he gives you an instruction, when he tells you to do something, do it. The mother of Jesus told the servant, said, look, listen, the man Jesus is here, whatever he tells you to do, do it. John 2 verse 5. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. And what was it? What did he tell him to do? They had run out of wine in a party. And Jesus shows up and he tells them, you go take water and go give it to the chairman of the party. I mean, come and think about it. You are the servant and you are given that kind of instruction. You know that it was water you took. You know where you took the water from. And then one Jewish rabbi now says, go and give it to your boss, that is wine. Of course, the first thing you come, right? Your natural human senses want to kick in. Right? Wants to kick in. That, sir, this is water. No, the man said wine. Sir, this is water. This is water. But what did they do? They obeyed. They obeyed. They were prompt in obedience and in absolute trust. And what did the Bible say? The moment they tasted that water, it was the best wine they ever had. So I'm saying this to you, that please, I beg you, don't try to analyze. I know we're all smart people, we're educated, we have, you know, PhD, FSD, MSD, whatever it is. You have all the degrees in the world, but the instructions of God, in fact, what the man of God said, if Satan knew that, quote unquote, touching Jesus would have done what he had, what he did, he never would have done it. Why? God's ways are not our ways. The Bible says that my thoughts are not your thoughts, and my ways are not your ways. As high as the heaven is above the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. God is smarter. He has been guiding the affairs of the earth for so long. So concerning you, you are not going to come up with one bright idea now. So tell your neighbor, say, promptly obey God with absolute trust. And then finally, this is so important, be fearless and courageous in acting on what God says. Be fearless and courageous in acting on what God says. Listen, those instructions that God will tell you to take is sometimes, right? It will require you to be courageous. Israel got to the border of Canaan, right? They sent out 12 spies to go search the land. And they came back and said, the land is full of milk and honey. Everything is good. It's a good land. Just like 2020 is a good year. But listen, 10 out of the 12 said, but there are giants in the land. Said, we are grasshoppers. They had a grasshopper mentality. Only two of them said, come on, let's take the land. We are able. Why? God is with us. That's going to be the difference maker for you. Because God is with you, you have to be fearless. Because God is with you, you have to be courageous. So I speak it to someone in this place. 2020, step out on faith. 2020, go ahead. Take that course. Go ahead, start that business. Go ahead, go back to school. Go ahead, apply for that job. Why? Because God is with you. God is with you. And when God is with you, who can be against you? Someone say nobody. So I beg you, the year 2020 is a covenant year of breakthroughs unlimited. You will experience breakthrough unlimited in the name of Jesus. Rise to your feet tonight. We're going to do two things. We're going to pray, and then we're going to seal it with the communion and enter into the new year with praise. We have just, you know, a little bit over 20 minutes. Hallelujah. One of the things that the enemy likes to do is to stop what God wants to do in our lives. But we are going to pray and we are going to destroy that. Come on, someone say amen to that. Amen. Look at what the Bible says. Let's use this scripture here. Hallelujah. Actually, let's go to Numbers 13, verse 33. If you have it, please give it to me. Numbers 13, verse 33. What it said there. It says, there we saw the giants. The descendants of Anak came from the giants, and we were like grasshoppers in our own sight. So we were in their sight. So these people, it was their own self-image that limited them. You are going to pray, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every wrong self-image, any wrong way I see myself, Father, destroy it in the name of Jesus. Come on, go ahead and pray that prayer. Father, every wrong self-image, every grasshopper mentality, every wrong way that I see myself, Father, destroy it in the name of Jesus. Father, let me see myself the way you see me. Father, let me see myself the way you see me. Every wrong self-image, Father, destroy it in the name of Jesus. Father, let me see as you see. Open my eyes to see myself as you see me. In the name of Jesus. Every grasshopper mentality, Father, destroy it in the name of Jesus. Every wrong self-image, Father, destroy it in the name of Jesus. Remove from me, oh God, every wrong self-image. Father, I will not limit your hand in my life. I will not limit your hand in my life in the year 2020. In the name of Jesus, Father, destroy every wrong self-image. Lord, 2020 will be to me according to that which you have said. Thank you, King of the universe. We give you all the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Yeah. Brethren, in that story, there were giants in the land for real. The truth was matter, there were giants in the land. But guess what? The greater one is inside of us. Someone say amen to that. So we are going to pray. Every giant, every satanic barrier the enemy wants to use to stop my breakthroughs unlimited, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Come on, go ahead and pray that prayer. I destroy every giant. I destroy every satanic barrier. I destroy every mountain that the enemy may want to use to stop my breakthroughs unlimited. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Come on, go ahead. The Bible says, speak to the mountain. The Bible says, I speak to this mountain. Be thou removed and be cast into the sea. Come on, in the name of Jesus, I speak against every satanic mountain, every satanic barrier, every giant that they want to stand in my way. In 2020, I destroy you in the name of Jesus. I come against you in the name of Jesus. Every satanic barrier.
To pass.
fulfill my heart's desires, exceed all my expectations. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I commit my way unto you. I trust also in you. Bring my way to pass. Bring my expectation to pass. Bring my desires to pass. Bring my expectation to pass. Come and pray, come and pray, come and pray. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Bring your word concerning me to pass. Bring your word concerning me to pass. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. I commit my way unto you. Father, bring every single one of my expectation to pass. Oh, yes, Lord. Nothing you have said concerning me will be unfulfilled. Every word will come to pass. Every desire will be fulfilled. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, King of the universe. Thank you, King of the universe. Begin your own praise, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And Lord, by your prayer, that second line said, trust also in him. I believe that this is everyone's single, most single important challenge to trust God. To trust him, to trust him, to trust him. Are you going to trust God? Listen, if you are going to trust God, you are going to have to believe in the supernatural. If you are going to trust God, you are going to have to believe that the invisible is more real than the visible. If you are going to trust God, you are going to believe in miracles. If you are going to trust him, because without trusting him, it doesn't happen. So you are going to say, Father, give me the grace to trust you. Come on, sisters, and consecrate that prayer. Father, give me the grace to trust in you. Father, give me the grace to trust in you. Father, give me the grace to trust in you. Father, give me the grace to trust in you. Yes, Lord. Father, give me the grace to trust in you. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Every head bowed, every eye closed. The best way you can trust God is to commit your life into his hands. That's the best way you can trust God. So if you are here today, you know your lifestyle is not right with God. You are still struggling with sin. The reason you struggle with sin is because your nature has not been changed. Like a dog has to bark, a sinner has to sin. He has no choice but to sin. So if you are still struggling with sin, my dear, it's because you are a sinner. But the good news is that Jesus paid the price on the cross. All you have to do is surrender your life to him. He comes in, removes that nature of sin, puts his own nature inside of you, and you find out no longer will sin have dominion over you. So you like to commit your life to Christ tonight. Would that be the sweetest testimony as I'm crossing into the new decade? I'm crossing into a new life. If you'd like me to pray with you, you want God to forgive you of your sin, you want to commit your life to him, or you used to be in Christ, you went back into sin, but you want God to restore you, put your hand upon your chest and I'll pray with you. The power of God will touch you. God will forgive you of your sin. You have a new nature tonight. The power of God will flow through you and you begin to live a life free of sin. A life victorious over sin. Anybody in the house tonight, if you'd like to pray that prayer of forgiveness with me, just put your right hand upon your chest and I'll pray with you. Or you're watching online, watching on social media, this same prayer goes. God bless you, my brother. I see someone over there. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? No one can make this choice for you but you. Thank you, King of the universe. My dear brother, with your hand upon your chest, along with everybody in the sanctuary and those watching, say this prayer after me. Say, Father, say it out loud. Say, Father, I thank you for Jesus who died for me. Today, I confess my sins. I ask that you forgive me. Give me the grace to live for you. I believe I'm born again. Say it out loud. I believe I'm born again. Thank you for saving me. in Jesus' name. Let me pray for you. Father, thank you. No one comes to you except you draw them. Thank you for my dead brother in the sanctuary. Thank you for those watching. Holy Spirit, reveal yourself to them. Give them the grace to know you and to live for you until they see you in glory. We give you all the praise. And the people of God say, amen. Amen. Come on, let's celebrate God. Let's join the heavenly hosts. Hallelujah. Quickly, quickly, before we break into praise and cross over, we're going to take the communion. We're going to take it really, really quickly. The communion, the night Israel came out, the Passover was instituted. The night Jesus was betrayed, before he went to the cross, he instituted the Holy Communion. Tonight, as we're about to cross over, we're also going to partake of the Holy Communion. We're going to seal everything God wants to do in 2020 for us. Someone say amen to that. Amen. The body of Jesus was broken so that you can live in 2020 free of sickness and disease. Someone say amen. Amen. And his blood was shed for us so that we can have victory. Victory over Satan, victory over sin. So when you are partaking of this communion tonight, I want you to eat with the revelation. And whatever you want your desire is to be fulfilled in 2020, you say, I connect it with this communion. And as God leads, you will have a sweet testimony in Jesus' name. Stretch your hands towards the communion. Father, Lord, as the people we agree, oh God, thank you for your body that was broken for us and your blood that was shed for us. We sanctify the elements of the communion in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. By this communion, your life is infused in us. By this communion, you engraft us even to the season of breakthroughs unlimited. Lord, let every sickness give way to health. Let every sorrow give way to joy. Let every stagnation give way to acceleration. Father, Lord, let victory break forth on every side. We give you all the glory. We sanctify it one more time in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You take the bread, you break it, you eat, and then you take the juice to drink, and you begin to celebrate God. Hallelujah. Come on, ministers, let us do it quickly. Let us do it quickly. Let us do it quickly, quickly, quickly. The moment you are served, just break the bread. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Yeah, you
come go ahead and thank him for feeding you with his body and his blood tonight. Come on, go ahead. There's life that is infused in you. Come on, thank him. You are set. You are set. You are set. You are set for 2020. You are set for 2020. Come on, go ahead and give him praise. Father, we celebrate you. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given that. Come on, someone say amen.
Amen.
Now, listen to me. Very, very important instruction. I've shown it to you in scripture. That is the presence of God that makes the difference. So what we are going to do now, in the next 10 minutes, as we cross over into the new year, we're going to praise God, we're going to dance and rejoice. As you are praising, as you are dancing, as you are rejoicing, the presence of God is enveloping you and you are crossing into the new year with His presence all around you. And I'm telling you, you will have a sweet testimony in that year. Come on, someone say amen to that. So choir, are we ready? I said, are we ready? Congregation, are we ready? Come on, let's go ahead.
Yeah!
to your season of change. I welcome you to your season of change. Come on, lift those hands to heaven. The Lord who has brought you gallantly into this new year, the Lord says to you, arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. As from today, it's the dawn of a new day for you. The glory of God covers you. Every single day of this year, you will shine. Every single day of this year, you will shine. The power of God will work for you. Because the Lord has arisen over you. Gentiles will come to your light. People you know, people you don't know will favor you. Institutions will favor you. God will send help your way. Helpers of destiny will connect with you. Gentiles will come to your light. And kings to the brightness of your rising. Everything that has been troubled in 2019, God will make it work in your favor. To package your offering tonight, to say thank you, Lord, for bringing me gallantly even to a new year. Hallelujah. The best way to give in DIC Cyprus is electronically. Text the word give to 832-789-4949. Or you can use our giving app, the Secure Give app. or on your phone, just navigate to our website, diccypress.org/give, diccypress.org/give. On there, you can give using the prompts. Also, if you're using Zelle, you can Zelle directly transfer your funds using our church email address, admin@diccypress.org. admin@diccypress.org. Use your bank cards, charge cards, or you want to go old school, write a check, or use cash. God bless you as you give. Choir are going to lead us in the last session of praise. While we're praying our offerings, we want to remind us that by God's grace, this coming Sunday, there's not going to be a service on Wednesday, but this coming Sunday is going to be our first Sunday service in this new year, and it's going to be a unique Thanksgiving anointed service. Someone say amen. Amen. But we're going to have only one service, the 11 a.m. service. We normally have two services on Sunday, but this Sunday, this first Sunday, will be only one service, 11 a.m. So please take note of that. That will be January the 5th at 11 a.m. The very next day, January the 6th, we begin our 21-day prayer and fasting. 21 days from January the 6th to January the 26th. We're going to be meeting in church 6:30 to 7:30 every day of the fast to pray, except on Sundays. Please take note of that. So it starts on Monday, so we're going to meet that Monday at 6:30 p.m. to 7:30 to pray. Please bring along your goal sheets. Bring along your expectation for the year 2020. In this kingdom, nothing happens until we put it to work. Someone say amen to that. The Bible says the kingdom of God suffers violence. The violence takes it by force. It's the force of prayer that we're going to use to unleash everything God has in store. So please take note of that. And if you are in church last Sunday, God has given us, you know, special instructions as a church. We're going to be unfolding that on the first Sunday, you know, of this January, you know, about our prayer campaign, about our evangelism campaign, and about our giving campaign for the year. So please, you don't want to miss on Sunday. We're going to be talking more and more on that. Come on, someone say amen. Yeah. All right, are we ready to offer it? Come on, let's rise up. Where can I have you? Lift up your offering envelope or the device that you're giving with this morning. Hallelujah, your first offering in the new year. That's an indication that every form of financial struggle has come to an end in your life. Amen. Come on, lift it up high above your head and wave it to the Father. Lord, we celebrate you. We give you all the glory because you are a good God. Thank you for this glorious year you have brought us into. We bring that first offering to you to say thank you. Command your blessing upon our seed. Command your blessing upon every life. Because we have seed to sow this first day of the year, lack has become a strange thing in our lives. Poverty has become strange in our lives. Lord, only abundance and prosperity is our portion. We give you all the praise. We give you all the worship. And the people of God said, amen. Hallelujah. I don't know. I'm feeling that hallelujah in a song. I'm really feeling it. Can we do that for offering? Can we? Is it okay? Hey, is it okay? Hallelujah. Come on. Let's dance as we give our offering. Over to you. Come on. Yeah. research that word hallelujah. That word means praise the Lord. And that word hallelujah is the only word in human history that is the same in every language. In heaven, on earth, under the earth, it's the only word that is the same in every language. And seven is the number of perfection. One of the promises that we have for this year, God said it will perfect everything that concerns us. So I'm going to lead us in shouting seven hallelujahs. And as you shout these hallelujahs, your 2020 is set. I said your 2020 is set. Listen to me. I always tell you, factor in the challenges into your journey. Don't be afraid of the challenges. They are part of the equation. They are stepping stones to your next level. Alright? But as you shout these hallelujahs, there's no challenge that you face that will overwhelm you this year. Come on, someone say amen to that. Is somebody ready? Establish what God wants to do. That's number one. DIC Cyprus, praise the Lord! DIC Cyprus, praise the Lord! DIC Cyprus, praise the
Breakthroughs on me.
I can't hear you. How are you doing today?
I experiencing breakthroughs on me.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Come on, talk to your neighbor. Say, I love you with the love of the Lord. And there's nothing you can do about it. Tell them, say, welcome to your year.